James Charles is in trouble again after more accusations that he inappropriately messaged a fan. James Charles' rise to fame has definitely included a ton of scandals along the way, most of which has put him at the center of some very heinous accusations. I'm gonna get into all the details in a moment, but first, if you could do us a big favor and smash that like button, we would really appreciate it. And with that out of the way, let's just dive right into today's video. So if you recall, back in May of 2019, YouTuber Tati Westbrook put together a 40-minute video where she exposed James Charles for attempting to trick straight men into being interested in him. Since that time though, James has also been caught on numerous occasions, leaving a few suggestive comments on accounts of people that he seems to be attracted to, most of which are celebrities, but sometimes, like today's allegations for example, normal people come into the mix. A 16-year-old boy on TikTok today has put out several videos that have since been deleted from the accuser's profile, where he quickly shows screenshots of different Snapchats that James Charles had apparently sent to him. Def Noodles, however, was able to get a hold of the clips, and in a tweet he writes, "Who could have seen that coming? James Charles exposed for allegedly messaging 15-year-old. When James notices that boy shared one of their messages on his story, James snaps, accuses the boy of lying about his age, then blocks him. Boy alleges he never lied about his age." Later adding, "The boy James Charles has been allegedly messaging is actually 16 years old, according to a message they shared on their Snapchat." The boy also shared several receipts in another video, next tweet and thread. Now all of this social media backlash comes after James Charles had put out probably one of the biggest responses I've ever seen, denying the allegations of that were levied against him. In the post he writes, "There's a video going around about me on TikTok and Twitter of a guy calling me a group and I want to address it right away. The accusation that I am person is completely false. Last week I came across someone on my Instagram explore page, saw he followed me and added him on Snapchat. The next morning I woke up to several snaps from this person being excited I added him back, saying he loved me, and also lewd photos of himself in the shower. I asked how old he was right away and he told me he was 18, so I started flirting back. In the excitement of meeting someone I thought could be potentially great, I didn't ask for a copy of his ID or passport. It's now clear based on the video he uploaded, he was taking photos of me with another device and had an ulterior motive from the beginning. Later in the day he said a few things that made me question the validity of his original age answer, and when I asked him to confirm his age once again, he admitted he was 16. I told him I was really uncomfortable and apologized for flirting, but he insisted on continuing talking, saying it could be our little secret. He's a fan of mine and would never tell anyone. I told him I wasn't okay with this, he started getting upset, and at this point I unfriended him. We haven't spoken since. I'm not victim blaming him or victimizing myself either, simply sharing what happened, and what happened was not okay. After false allegations like this in the past, I would never knowingly engage with anyone age and put my life on the line for a few Snapchats. Because of situations like this, instead of taking someone's word for it, I now will ask to see the ID or password of every guy I have a conversation with." Right away, as I was reading the part where he starts exposing the kid for trying to cover it up, that to me is victim blaming. He can follow it up with saying that it's not, but that doesn't make it so. To me, James is the adult in this situation. I mean, he literally is the adult in this situation. And as an adult that operates from a position of power, you really need to be careful when speaking to your fans. And James Charles is still a human being that deserves to find love and affection, but he definitely should not be looking for that through his Instagram DMs, or Snapchats for that matter. Also, I find it odd that he sort of promised the public that he will start checking the IDs of people he's romantically interested in. Hey, he didn't even say romantically, he just said guys he was talking to. To me, that's a huge red flag. Like, you are so attracted to younger looking people and gotten yourself in so much trouble for hitting on that you have to openly say, "Okay guys, okay, now I'm gonna start checking IDs. Nope, not a single one of you getting past me now. Yeah, let me see that ID." Like, it's very weird, right? Like, even Variety Magazine also reported this week that James Charles will not be brought back to host the Instant Influencer series, and even though YouTube avoided citing this incident as the reason, many fans are assuming that this is why. These new screenshots of receipts, though, certainly show an ugly side of James Charles, and we will have to wait and see if he continues to deny the allegations.
And today I wanted to talk about some of the influencers that tried to warn us about James Charles, but sadly we did not listen. I'm Mackenzie, make sure to subscribe if you're new here, and let's get into it. And at number 10, Jeffree Star is one of the people we know orchestrated the Bi Sister scandal to call out James on his power-hungry behavior. He was also the first person that supported Tati's claims before other big influencers stepped in as well. Hours after Tati released Bi Sister, Jeffree tweeted that James was banned from his home and is, quote, a danger to society, adding that his boyfriend Nate felt uncomfortable around James. After some backlash, Jeffree walked back his claims temporarily, but provided evidence of a voice memo from a James Charles a year later on the Mom's Basement podcast. YouTuber Blair White also came forward on her channel saying that she heard the voice memo and believes the accuser, who's actually a big YouTuber. And I mean, it really doesn't seem like Jeffree was lying about his claims after all. However, I definitely don't think he should have shared that voice memo with anybody. And at number 9, Trisha Paytas. Trisha Paytas is probably the influencer that has been the loudest in her disdain for James Charles, before many of the allegations against him even came out. One of the biggest feuds between Trisha and James happened while Trisha was feuding with Charli D'Amelio. video, following her entitled comment about not getting 100 million followers yet. In defense of Charlie, James tweeted out that people should be less harsh on Charlie, then taking a dig at Trisha by saying, quote, 30 plus year olds dragging someone half their age feels familiar. Trisha clapped back savagely, writing, quote, poor parenting on your parents and James for allowing you to be friends with Tati, a middle-aged woman while you were a teen. Unfortunately, you were the big then, but now Charlie is. You being friends with her is predatory. Trisha then followed up with another tweet slamming James, saying, quote, definitely have always said no one deserves to be canceled. Everyone has room for growth / positive influence, except James Charles. Please cancel him. He's a forever victim with a superiority complex. He's never said so in his whole life and hangs out with an girl regularly. And even though Trisha got a lot of heat for those comments at the time, she turned out to be right. In at number 8, Ethan and Ella Klein. Ethan and Ella got into a heated feud with James Charles after they accused him of stealing their color block merch from their clothing line, Teddy Fresh. In response to James's announcement, Ethan tweeted out, quote, I know we didn't invent color blocking, but I'm having a hard time with the new James Charles merch. It's the same exact design as Ella's. Combined with the fact that his audience is so huge, many people will assume he designed it and start accusing us of plagiarism. What do you think? James responded back saying the two had DM'd, and James claimed that he didn't know of their designs. Ethan continued to speak out about the similarities on Twitter, share text messages sent by James, and compare the situation to Charles accusing makeup brand Wet n Wild of copying his eyeshadow palette. James didn't respond any further and ended up going forward with the launch anyways. In at number 7, Tati Westbrook. Y'all already know that Tati had to be on this list because she was the first person who had the courage to go up against James and his massive audience. She uploaded the infamous Bye Sister cancellation video in May of 2019. And in the 40-minute video, she explained why James is shady, two-faced, and has no loyalty to his friends. This was because James promoted her competitor, Sugar Bear Hair. She also made serious claims about Charles, alleging that he leveraged his fame to manipulate boys into being with him romantically. James denied these claims, and Tati ended up deleting her video. As a result of the allegations, James lost a record 3 million YouTube subscribers at the time. However, he later uploaded a video with more proof than Tati provided, and he was able to win everybody back, until he was recently exposed again. Tati hasn't spoken out on the situation since, but I honestly have a feeling that she will very soon. In at number 6, Zara Larsson. Zara Larsson is another celebrity that jumped on the bandwagon against James Charles after the Bye Sister video was uploaded. Apparently, James had actually DM'd her boyfriend before. She tweeted out saying, quote, I'm cackling because he hit up my boyfriend in the DMs several times, knowing damn well he's straight. However, after the tweet went incredibly viral, Larsson confirmed that it was actually only one DM along with multiple comments on Instagram. James actually responded to her call out in his response video called No More Lies, where she appeared to be in the wrong. Later on, she decided to address the situation in a long thread where she apologized, but she also somewhat stood by her decision to call him out, writing in part, quote, what seems to be the thing here is that my boyfriend wasn't the only one, and that's why I don't condone this behavior. You have, for example, previously tweeted saying that straight men will be the death of you, etc., which is concerning considering the fact that they will never give consent since they don't play for Team D. Halfway at number 5, Jeff Wittick. Even though Jeff is straight, that didn't stop James Charles from flirting with him. James made multiple videos with Jeff and the Vlog Squad, and in the videos, it's clear that James is flirting with Jeff. He even named one video they did together, quote, the truth, my crush does my makeup. And although in the video, it's clear that they're just, you know, joking around a lot of the time, it's hard to tell if Jeff actually ever felt uncomfortable because of James. After James's cancellation, Jeff actually defended James on a podcast, telling the world that he never felt uncomfortable around James. But a lot of people didn't buy it and think that could be the reason that James and the Vlog Squad were never really close after the flirty videos came out. In at number 4, Marlena Stell. Marlena Stell is an OG member of the beauty community on YouTube and helped make it what it is today. However, James showed that he has no respect for others in his community when he came for her. The feud between them started when Marlena tweeted out that she was going to be working on a documentary with Netflix about the beauty community. James responded to the announcement in a tweet saying, quote, wait, what? Saying how he was planning to make a documentary on the beauty community and he was livid. Adding, quote, everything that I put my heart and love and a ton of work into is always stolen by someone. Marlena responded that she was approached by Netflix and said it would be great to hear from an influencer for her documentary. James, however, didn't accept her response and the feud continued for hours. In at number 3, Gage Gomez. Gage Gomez was the first influencer to call James out for his behavior towards men. After James took Gage to Coachella, Gage uploaded a video to YouTube talking about his experience, in which he claimed he was manipulated by James from January up until Coachella. Throughout the video, Gomez claims that James pressured him to hang out and tried to manipulate him, saying, quote, James saw this as an opportunity to manipulate me as a person who may or may not have been trying to figure things out about their preferences. After the fact that I told him I was straight multiple times, James responded that Gage never told him that he was straight and that Gage was just clout chasing. And in number two, Stephen Harrison. Stephen Harrison shared some DMs he got from James Charles while James was in the midst of his bi sister scandal. Stephen, who posts screenshots of people who hit on him all the time, shared the details on Instagram. Basically, James DM'd him pretty bluntly, saying, quote, you're so hot. Stephen responded back saying, my wife's so hot. James then responded back that he could have just accepted the compliment. Then Stephen replied that he finds it more of a compliment when people say nice things about his marriage. When sharing the screenshots online, Stephen said, quote, don't ever feel you should accept a compliment, even if it's by a dude with 16 million followers. And finally, at number one, Tana Mojo. Tana Mojo used to be really good friends with James, but then all of a sudden it stopped and no one was really sure why. However, after Gage's Coachella feud with James, Tana and Gage actually became really close, with Tana seemingly taking Gage's side in things. Tana tweeted out years later claiming that she was actually manipulated by James. This started when Tana responded to a tweet referencing that she had took James' side publicly at first, but Tana set the record straight, tweeting out, quote, 100% manipulated and begged to tweet that. I was defending someone that was my friend at the time and I believed them, sad to see. Later reconciled with Gage and discussed it, apologized, heard his side of the story, and now I call him one of my closest friends. Things change.
Beauty influencer James Charles is finding himself in a whole new world of trouble after just recently being accused several times of inappropriately texting underage fans. That controversy actually led to the demonetization of his YouTube channel and his removal as host from the upcoming YouTube show called Instant Influencers. Now he's being sued by a former employee named Kelly Rockline, who worked as a video editor and producer. Recently, Kelly tweeted out a few cryptic messages that led many people online to dig into what exactly was going on between these two. In the tweet, she said, watching the same people who screwed me over massively and up in deep scandals isn't news to me, it's karmic debt, which was shortly followed up with 1-1 going 2-for-2 because I'm all about law and order. Eventually, other drama and commentary channels were able to discover that a lawsuit had been filed by Kelly against James in which she cited wrongful termination. Among the issues surrounding her departure, Kelly also apparently dealt with not receiving all of her wages on time, disability discrimination, and a failure to provide reasonable accommodation. There are also other parts to this lawsuit that address issues regarding overtime payment and overall poor treatment of Kelly while she was an employee. According to Kelly, she ended up working in two different job roles for James Charles. This left her working almost 12 hours a day and 7 days a week without any overtime pay, despite that and a raise all being promised to her. Not only that, but she also provides a story of sustaining a head injury causing symptoms that she would require a hospital visit for, only for James to say that her leaving meant she wasn't dedicated enough. Again, according to Kelly, he apparently fired her after she returned from medical leave and did not pay her a dime while she was off work. Documents online and several media outlets are also reporting that James has denied all of Kelly's allegations, but this case is far from settled, so if there are any further updates on this, we will be sure to bring them to you. Now with that though, let's check out some of your comments from the video titled, 5 Arrested, Lady Gaga Dog Walker Update, Meme Makes 500K, and T-Pain Ignores Celebs in DMs. It's a whole whack of news. T-Bone says, thought this dude had my name in the title. close, but not really. Seth Freakin' Mullen says, those who shot the dog walker deserve to be locked up in jail. Oh, definitely, and I'm sure they will face the full force of the law. Oscar says, I'm so glad they're back with Gaga. Must have been so stressed and scared. Yeah, I couldn't imagine what that must feel like to just know that they're out there somewhere and just hoping that someone finds them or sees them and brings them back to you. Just absolutely heartbreaking. So it's great that they're finally back with their owner. Jack Howell says, I often wonder about Johnny's book collections and love to know a few of these titles he has on the shelves. Well, clearly you can see, well, I don't know if clearly is a good word, but I have some Goosebump books. Those are just old childhood collections. There's some comedy books, like biographies, like, oh yeah, 48 Laws of Power. There's one title for it. We'll slowly unveil them. Cindy Paul says, glad it has a good ending for Lady G. Certainly, we're so happy that those dogs were finally able to go back to Lady Gaga's house and that the attackers were all arrested. That, to me, is amazing that they were able to catch them even. Beauty influencer James Charles had built himself quite the lucrative career over the years, but as the days go by, new accusations are slowly chipping away. As of late, the 21-year-old multimillionaire has been at the center of a controversy regarding him texting people that were underage. Rampage. The online backlash led to him losing monetization on his YouTube channel and cutting ties with Morph Cosmetics. Now his former producer and creative director Kelly Rockline is speaking out yet again regarding her lawsuit against him. Kelly is alleging wrongful termination, disability discrimination, failure to provide reasonable accommodation, and failure to pay minimum wage for overtime hours worked. During an interview with Insider, Kelly and another anonymous source also alleged that James had used the N-word in front of them. Initially, Rockline said that she wanted to settle with James privately, but apparently his legal representation declined to settle during their early conversations back in 2019, saying that they would rather litigate the dispute in private arbitration. Then in March of 2020, Kelly decided to file her complaint with the Los Angeles County Superior Court. Now, of course, James has declined to comment on Kelly's recent claim that he used a racial slur in front of her, and through his attorney, he has essentially denied all of the claims that she has made against him. On the flip side of things, James Charles posted a video to his Twitter further explaining the lawsuit in question. James took that time to also accuse Kelly of taking her story to the media to publicly pressure him into offering a higher settlement offer. He then went on to question why she has chosen now to discuss their legal dispute that has been going on for 2 years. In response to this recent video, Kelly's attorney told media outlets that the reason for her waiting so long to speak about this is because of the legal team for James Charles. According to Kelly's attorney, James's legal team have been attempting to compel arbitration, which is a private process where disputing parties agree that one or several individuals can make a decision about the dispute after receiving evidence and hearing arguments. Basically, it's a process where both sides kind of come together and agree to follow and respect the decision of a neutral mediator. This is one route that you can try instead of filing a lawsuit and going to court to resolve a dispute. Kelly, on the other hand, wanted to set a precedent for how influencers treat their employees. By going through the process of litigation to be compensated, she will then set a template for future cases or disputes of this nature. Rockline told Insider that she is hoping to be compensated for unpaid wages that she says were withheld from her, along with damages, penalties, attorney fees, and interest from the 3 years since she was fired. Despite working 80 hours a week or more, Kelly says that she was not paid any overtime at minimum wage even. However, it is also worth noting that she did say in a perfect world that she would still work for James Charles, whatever that means. That being said, she also exposed him for using the N-word in front of her on numerous occasions, claiming that he would use it casually while filming, and that he would also refer to his friends using the slur as well. Backing this claim up is another source who claims to have had a personal relationship with James prior to 2016. They too said that Charles would casually use the slur in front of them in high school. Kelly's attorney has also responded to the claims made by James that she is blackmailing him. In response to that, he said that James Charles' legal team attempted to stop the story from Insider.com by offering a settlement in response to Rockline's claims to buy her silence. James Charles' manager responded to that and told Insider, "James made a reasonable settlement offer for an employment lawsuit. She countered with an outrageous amount of money to settle and to retract her public statements. James wasn't willing to pay her off." As for James, well, he is still defending the fact that he has never paid anyone off, nor will he ever. During his recent video, he confirms this as much, saying, "Contrary to popular belief, I have never paid anybody to speak or not speak about me, and this will not be the first time that I do it." Adding, "My only option is to pursue this to the fullest extent of the law and hope that when it gets to a courtroom, justice will be served." I wonder if bringing this to a courtroom, though, is just going to open up a can of worms that James Charles doesn't want to expose. Either way, we would love to hear your thoughts on this developing situation, so don't forget to leave us a comment down below.